Hey everybody, welcome to Let's Play Dreadnought. This game is, I believe, still in closed beta as the time of, at the time of recording anyway. This is what I've been filling the hole that Star Conflict left. Because I can't play Star Conflict
I'll
anymore.
scan the feeds and find you a job.
Also, I have my graphical settings turned way down, way down than when I normally play. I tried recording some episodes with my settings all the way up and getting a lossless video with the max settings on this game is actually giving my computer issues, which that's the first thing I've ever seen give my computer issues. This game looks stunning in at the highest settings, actually. Like, the detail is wonderful. Doesn't look bad on medium settings, but meh, it's okay. It's sort of like the same feel I get for like PlanetSide. PlanetSide 2 looks amazing in max settings. It really does. But honestly, all the flashiness, it does hinder you ever so slightly in game. Not even for like loss of frames or anything. It's just that, foliage being well defined means you can't actually see through the foliage, things like that. But in this game, I do have to turn it down for recording's sake, unfortunately. And I oddly enough do not see too many people playing this game. Or at least there's not that many videos out on it, but it's so good. It's really good. Like, it's not quite the same as Star Conflict, which is, I mean, of course it wouldn't be, it's a different game, but it doesn't have that verticality that Star Conflict had. It also, I noticed the further I got into Star Conflict, the more customizable the ships were. The more I could swap out parts and things like that, and I really like that. This game, not sure, I haven't played that far. I'm still really low rank and not actually that good at the game. I haven't noticed that much customization in this game. Like, primary weapons specifically cannot be swapped out, from my understanding. Just from the only ship that I currently own, as well as some other players talking that I've noticed in chat. So let's start talking about how the game actually plays here. Currently my loadouts are all the same ship, they're all in Nox, and they just have slightly different things on them. I think these two are the exact same. I don't know how to like get rid of a loadout. I think once you have a certain amount of loadouts I can probably kill one, but it's whatever. This is the only loadout I've really been using, just because it's the one I've customized. But you start off with these trader ships. And these trader ships are actually really good. Just a quick rundown of them. Dreadnoughts are tanks, sort of. Like, they have a lot of armor, and they're really beefy guys with a lot of HP, and they. The plasma broadside, which is the first module you'll see, like right in this area when I hover over it, is really nice. Corvettes are your assassins in this game. Think if you're coming from the Star Conflict scene, these are like goodness, it's been so long since I was actually able to play Star Conflict. The guys with the plasma swords, I forgot what they're called. But you know what I'm talking about. The little ships get right up on you and then cut you to pieces, right? That's basically the Corvettes in this game. Artillery are snipers. There's not really that much to be said. They just are. If I actually show you, it'll load it up. It's just a big gun. It's just a big gun that roams around in space. Well, we're about to get in there, and then beyond that, there's like a bruiser ship that's more of a DPS, I suppose, than anything. I use it as a bruiser because the default loadout, it seems like it's built to be a bruiser. even though it seems like that ship is very much DPS based. And of course there's the healer, and the healer is actually deceptively strong. If I can pull him up right quick, this guy. I think this is a healer as well, so there's no need. And I don't know what these ships are. All the ships do look different in the game, and I'm not too familiar. I'll actually play support this time. My first game of the day, I actually started recording today and didn't worry out. Didn't worry out at all. Just because I had the settings way too high and it started freaking out on me. Turns out I can't run this game twice at max settings and everything be okay. And I also had a whole bunch of other videos that I was able to successfully record at max settings, but it wasn't, for whatever reason, it didn't have the same issues as the more recent one. Alright, so this Healy ship, it has a healing beam, has Tesla coils, a repair pod, and a blast pulse. The blast pulse is a defensive mechanic. This is why these ships are pretty good, actually. They have that beam attack there, and it's so strong, just because it can't miss, pretty much. And the healing actually gets you a lot of points, and I really need to rank up in this game, so points are nice to have. Gonna drop a repair pod. It's fine. This is gonna be a really slow match. I actually don't know how to ping people like that, like how they put a target on that guy. No clue.
Enemy warheads locked on our position.
Oh, that guy's dead apparently. Nice. We're being very defensive. I didn't realize that this little guy was a healer as well, or is that guy the healer? Are we all healers? Are we all healers in one dreadnought? Is that what we're doing now? I can just face tank this with my shielding. Alright. This isn't quite as high octane as some of my other games go, because I'm playing support, but I do want to get some talking in this time, because whenever I play the other ship classes, I usually don't get as much information out. I do not like where the healing pulse thing goes, the repair drone goes. It tends to get right up in my way. Block my view. That is a warp. He's about to jump right up on us. Alright, I do want to activate this. Activate the repair drone. He's gone. Now I can focus on healing. And oddly enough, if I could explain how this particular support ship plays in my, well, at least the way I tend to play it, it plays a lot like D&D clerics do, where you have the capability to heal and you can probably do it really well, but you can also fight. Like, you're not strictly there for health. Like, nothing's gotten close enough for me to fight it, but this ship can fight. It has Tesla coil turrets, basically, that I can drop whenever it gets in a fight, as well as this blast pulse that I haven't been able to use yet. And the blast pulse is really good as well. It's just an explosion around you that does damage. The auto repair can keep you alive for quite a while. And this laser does do peanut damage. It's not really meant to be taken on this tank, basically, but I want to pester him. Get my allies up. Oh, and it has, like, a million range. Yeah, see, that's what I'm talking about. That guy just warped in on top of me, and with the help of my ally, we were able to just completely melt him. There aren't many ships in this game that I feel like, well, let's put it this way. I feel like the game is very well balanced for the ships that are available. I'm gonna try to keep our sniper alive while he's getting wrecked. I don't know what that sound is, by the way. It's not my healing laser. I know that. Maybe it is my healing laser, because I've heard that sound before playing as other ships, and there was no one near me, so I was pretty confident that it wasn't the healing laser. Guess I was wrong. Our sniper's in a really bad place. He's about to get super wrecked by this Corvette if he's not careful. Yeah, I could have tried to save him, but why? That's not a good place for a sniper to be, especially if he's not going to use his cloak ever. You gotta stay cloaked as a sniper.
Firing. Systems depleted, Captain.
Where did he go?
Put the energy system offline.
This healing ship is going to lead us right to him. See, that Tesla coil does not fuck around. You gotta be careful around these support ships, especially when I have backup like this. I mean, it's like a Sounds like a not strong selling point when I say it like that. Better be careful when I have all my friends around, but it's really the case. And also, like I said before, the range at which these things can actually, like, heal their allies and hurt people is pretty far. Is that a tractor beam? I think it is.
Captain, the enemy's gaining ground.
This guy's done. Too far away to hit. Do you want to take a look back here to see this guy trying to flank us? My Tesla coil picked up a kill for me, that's good. We have too much healing on our team. They don't have enough burst damage or AoE damage, so like I said, these healing ships, man, they're so good. They're really defensive, they're really strong. Looks like that ship has automatic healing on it, which is pretty nice. Like it just auto heals anything nearby. Yeah, this is great.
Hi, Captain. Building a new repair pod now. System drained.
Oh, I couldn't save him. Those little fighters always freak me out because they look like they could be Corvettes in the distance. I think I just killed a fighter, though.
Hi, Captain. Engaging. System drain. Cycling.
I feel like I've seen this strategy before, and I can't remember where. Oh, yeah. Never mind. It's happened in a lot of different games, but I'm thinking about whenever you have engineers standing behind tanks in Planet Side again. Or behind Max's.
You're the boss.
Put the Tesla coil out. He's gonna come try to flank us. I wanna get low. Not that low. Positioning is strange in this game because things are very weighty and don't move very fast. Alright, there's something coming right up on top of me.
Sending pulse countermeasures, high captain, engaging. Full power to maneuvering thrusters. Captain, the pod's in place.
This is craziness. It's we're winning pretty hard though, so.
Prepare pod is away. System drain. Starting cooldown.
I'll distract him and hopefully our Corvette will get in there.
Incoming, Captain. We don't have launch capability yet.
The broadsides are gonna hurt.
Ship's been hit. We need some support.
Who's hurt? Not you. Oh, that guy way over there.
Thanks for the assist.
Float the pod? Aye, Captain. Systems depleted, Captain.
This is great. Heal tanking all day. This guy's hurt.
Amplifying weapon systems.
So in this game, like, anything that ups damage usually ups the healing rate as well, because weapons are used for healing. Missiles? Oh.
Prepare pod is away. I've got nothing left.
Being up by about 20 points is really big. It's like 4 kills, I think.
Amplifying weapons on.
Aye, Captain.
Nice. Save this dude's nuts. Yeah, they haven't gotten a kill in a while. This match is gonna take forever, but I'm enjoying the fact that I don't think I've died yet. Oh.
That's how you get the job.
Okay, I guess time ran out. Alright, let's see where I'm at. Second to last. It's from the better you did, the further to the outside you are. Yeah, all healer is pretty gross, apparently. Alright, let's go look at the market. I do have enough for another ship, even though I don't think I've actually shown off what my ship is supposed to do. I don't too much enjoy that ship, to be completely honest. Gotta be rank 15 to get these ships. Cost 8,000. Gotta be rank 25 to get these. So it has that progression system as well that I'm not too fond of. And it actually has the whole progression tree right here. First thing you unlock is bomb catapults for anything that can use it, as well as a tractor beam pod for anything that can use it. It just drags enemies in. Plasma ram for the destroyer seems really, really funny to me. Aim your ship at the enemy and use this module to charge forward, delivering a punch to the target. They deal super high damage. So I guess I want to get a destroyer if at all possible. And I mean, I don't mind spending some in-game currency here. Let's see. I can get the Gora. Gora is the heaviest ship of its kind. Mobility traded for firepower and sturdy armor. That's not true. There's a much bigger destroyer somewhere else. Workhorse of the Colonial Navy. This thing, the Monarch, I want it. Want it pretty bad. Fastest ship of its type, blah, blah, blah. Alright, you know what? We're gonna buy this thing. Tempest, Salvo, Energy Generator. It's basically the kind of ship that I like anyway. Sure, we'll get it, and we will see what it can do.
Now that's a nice ship. You treat her well.
Alright, we go back to... always go to dashboard, and I mess it up. Go to the hangar, we'll trade this out for... the Gora. See, they all the ships, they only have one thing here. I don't think I've used that before. Flak turrets can be traded out for rocket turrets and light particle turrets. Range up. This one's got decent range. It's got tempest missiles. Yeah! Let's try to ram somebody. 1,000?! Alright, I'll do it. I don't like
it. Don't forget to equip that bad boy.
It's equipped already. Drain torpedo. Fires torpedo that drains the energy out of your target. Small blast radius. It's not very good. Disruptor. Disrupts any abilities and prevents it from further using abilities. That's pretty neat, actually. Then it has a weapons booster missile. Increases damage output of its target. Oh, you hit your allies with it. Medium auto guns, I think I'll keep. Jump drive. Oh, this could be really funny. This module instantly warps your ship forward a long distance. You can target it allies and enemies. Just jump right up on them. Oh, it's got... I gotta use that, right? I gotta. Yep. Alright, let's do this. Let's get in there.
Choose
and
the type of job you want. I'll scan the feeds and find you a job.
Let's go ram something. And then there's these things, which we must get way later. Rank 7. It's not that much later. And these, I believe, are the same across all of the ships. Across all the ships, it's the same. And you can, like, change them out. Yeah, I remember all these names. Alright, so I got my cat. Default Nox, I'll actually trade out for the default Gora. Tempest Torpedo Salvo, Medium Auto Guns, yeah. That's fine. These are just cannons, I take it. For the one with a ram, we can actually rename it. Just ram. Ram's fine. We'll set it as a flagship so that whenever it, whenever we queue for matchmaking, it'll be the first one that we jump to automatically. And there was something else I wanted to do, and I can't remember what it was. I think it was to look over this. Oh, the ram moved to slot 1, right? Look over the cat. I don't remember if I've shown this off yet or not. And I also want to check any pulse. I don't want it, any nuke. I mean, I get why it's useful, but I really want to get proximity mines, but not for this ship in particular. This thing comes default with siege mode. You increase your weapon damage, and I believe it also makes it shoot faster, but I might be wrong there. But then it completely stops you. And also depletes all your energy, which I'm not really okay with, because the gun on this ship isn't very good. It's okay, but it's not very good. Again, if I haven't brought it up yet, the sniping ships, if you compare them to actual sniper rifles, this particular ship is a semi-automatic sniper rifle. It's meant for taking a lot of shots and moving around a lot, I guess, which, I don't know. I've never been fond of semi-automatics in sniping, as far as in games go, because games have to balance these things. And sniper rifles IRL don't really care about whether they're semi-automatic or whatever. The size of the bullet will be the size of the bullet no matter what. That seems insane. Sentry pods. Oh no 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 no! Now I get it. It's a scanner, basically. I get it. Yep, took me a minute. Increasing your fire times. That's fine. It's only 3 seconds though, and that's not very good. This one's 5 seconds. Well, it might be okay actually. It seems like every time I've ever actually used siege mode, it seems like it lasts pretty long. So maybe I'm discounting how long 5 or 3 seconds is in a battle. This is actually not a very good description of the stationary cloak. It says, status effect is cloak, cloak quality is high, the break condition is move, and the duration is 20 seconds, the cooldown is 40 seconds. The break condition's wrong. If you move, you become a lot more visible, but it doesn't break it. It doesn't break your stealth. There's actually, if you look at the trader ships, you go to this. Medium cloak. Status effect. Cloaks your ship. Quality, average. Breaks on firing and taking damage. Those are true. For the other one as well, I believe. If you fire or take damage with the other ship, it also breaks. Basically, what you use that for is on the Svarog here. This one actually has a good sniper rifle on it. It's a semi-automatic, clip size 1, reload time 3, damage fall off none, has a whole bunch of range, and just hurts. It just hurts things. This is really good for that, because it massively boosts weapon damage. What it doesn't tell you is that it also makes the firing happen faster, if I'm not mistaken. I might be wrong, because I've spent too much time playing the other ship, but it's really good. The light flat cannons. Almost none of the secondary weapons are good in this game. They're just awful. I mean, they should be, because they're secondary weapons. They're not primaries. They're not something you should be using a lot. But they're actually useful for this ship, because this particular ship, because of and it's not just this ship. There are a few different ones that have different guns. This one cannot fire in all directions, because this whole barrel right here determines its firing vector. It doesn't have to be quite perfect, as this would indicate, because this seems like it would have to be directly forward. It has a 20 degree firing cone, something like that, in front of the ship. Maybe more than that. But one of the big advantages of the Nox, and actually says it in here, it's the engineers built the only long-range weapon system that is able to deliver 360-degree firing angle for an artillery cruiser. Yeah. So it's can fire in all directions, which is okay, I guess, if you get flanked, but then that makes the secondary completely useless. But I do want to try this, because it seems interesting. Just because it has a lot more range. Actually, it's just worse. Never mind. The flak turrets aren't that good, so the bolt gun turrets probably are not good either, even at their increased range. So, that's useless. There we go. Finally found a match. 8 minutes. Jesus. Doesn't usually take that long to find a match, to be honest. Sometimes the game bugs out like this whenever you find a match mid whatever. Gotta click on the ship again. I don't know what all this thing can do. Dual repeaters, not only good accuracy but adequate damage at medium ranges. We don't want that. Beam turrets. The fire rate's good, but damage fall off is steep. It's only good at super close range, and as a beam, that's not good either. Heavy torpedo's good. Any pulse missile or any missile pulse is good. Afterburner. This is just basically the default loadout for the trader ship you start off with. But the trader ship has a better gun on it. Well, it depends. I don't know if the other one has 360 firing range, but I think I might play the Corvette this time just to show it off. The stock Corvette is really, really good. It depends on what the enemy brings and what our people bring. I'll try to conform to bring something useful. Oh, no, that's right. We're ramming. We ramming now. One thing I enjoy, and I know this is the little thing that shouldn't matter, I'm all the way on one side, and I'm not always on this side, so they actually do load you in, like there's actually 5 slots to load in on, if that makes sense. I'm currently all the way to the right. I have been, you know, more towards the center a few times in different spots. I don't know. It's a little thing.
Action station.
It's a little thing that shouldn't matter.
Enemy ships inbound.
I'm just gonna... I just wanna ram someone. That's all I want. Oh my god, did somebody just teleport to us? No, that's somebody on our team teleported forward a short distance. Didn't do nearly as much damage as I thought it would. Gonna do it again though. I'm probably gonna cost us this game just trying to ram people. And I hate it. I hate that I'm gonna do this, but it seems really gimmicky, and you guys know how much I love gimmick stuff. So that's where I'm gonna show up.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters. Locked out the target. Activate plasma ramp, my captain. That's why you're the captain.
Let's clear all that and then ram this other guy.
Got to reload. Stand by.
Oh no.
Punch it.
Put right by him.
Lock on confirmed. Clearing torpedo tube. Shield activated. Enemy warhead blast at our position.
Oh my goodness, I thought I was closer than I was. Yeah, I shouldn't have tried to ram that soon. It's gonna put me in front of him? No!
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
Oh, it's so good. Get out of here.
Got to reload. We have weapon lock. Torpedo launched.
Captain, we need to turn this around. Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
Plasmaran charging up.
Did I get him? Yeah, I got him. It's so good. Please help. Oh goodness. The plasma ram, man, it's so good. So good. No one expects the plasma ram. Gone, he's dead, yeah. Yeah, if they play a bunch of Corvettes, I'm not gonna be able to ram anything, unfortunately. I need to get something in my sights here. Yeah, wasted my auto guns. Just let all those missiles crash.
Need some repairs.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
Where did he go? There he is.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
It doesn't move as far as I would like it to.
Launching torpedoes. We've got to wait for the autoguns to recharge. Contact eliminated.
We're getting killed out here. Shield activated.
Enemy warhead lock on our position.
Oh goodness. I got the healer. Couldn't get the tank. How am I doing? I'm actually at the top. Either that or just I'm there because of whatever and I'm not paying attention. In other words, it might not be sorted by score.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
This is hilarious to me.
Thank you.
The fact that it's the game doesn't have good verticality, as in I can't tilt my ship upwards very well. I can do this. Whenever I start moving upwards, it'll sort of move up a little bit.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
But it's not a very good, I can't tilt. Heal me. Get him! I jumped past him, and I should have just ran right at him and then rammed him, because I don't think he was expecting it, but I did want to close the distance, and then I ended up landing right on top of him. I've got to get used to it, I guess. Are you an enemy? No, okay. Didn't say right away. Gonna need some energy in order to catch this guy. I don't really want him to see me coming though.
Requesting fire at this location.
Oh, there's someone closer. After that guy. Why am I going that way? Did I just get tractor beamed? Because that'd be super annoying if that was the case. Double kill. Not much I could do about that. Enemies are that way. I need a turn. Okay. Just need to.
Ship's hull down to 50%, Captain. Punch it.
Yep, it just shoots me in the direction I'm pointed. Which I'm a bit dissatisfied with. I had to be completely honest about it.
Requesting fire over here.
Oh, that's game. We lost.
We've lost this one, Captain.
Oh well.
Driving, get the hell out of here.
I had fun. I rammed people. It's really tough to get in good positions to ram. Look at me up there at the top. Can't handle my ram? They handled my ram. I don't know what I'm talking about. Did I finally unlock tractor beam? It's a trap. I don't know what that means. Like, I don't know why it's a thing that I can unlock. 7 and 4, not bad, not bad. Did pretty well, actually, if I do say so myself. The ramming is hilarious. Let me go see what this thing's talking about right quick. This, I've already got this. Repair auto beams, that's new. Anti-nuke lasers, okay, I didn't realize I got all that. I now have module recycler. Module cooldown goes down by 15 seconds whenever I kill something. That could be useful for things with low cooldowns, obviously. This module scrambles the screens of nearby ships. It's used for a destroyer, which is... it's okay, I guess, depending on which slot it takes. Tractor beam is for dreadnoughts, which I wish it was for destroyers, I guess, so I could pull them into my ram. And then blast pulse for corvettes, not a big fan of, to be honest. It's just extra damage. Alright, let me go to the hangar and see if there's anything that I want to do with this. Scrambler pulse instead of medium auto guns? Absolutely not. Torpedo salvo can use disruptor missile, which stops them from using anything, instead of torpedo salvo. Range is a lot more range. The cooldown goes way up. This cooldown's really high anyway. I like the torpedo salvo. I get right up in people's faces anyway. Alright. I guess that's where I'll call it. So yeah, this is Dreadnought. Slow, weighty, you know, space sim. It's pretty nice. I like the battles. If you want to see more in the future, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and all that jazz, I guess. Yeah, see you next time.